bad for some starving down and outs. They can pummel us hard as they like, but we will always get back up and fight. That's who we are. Outlaws for life, fellas. Wait until we have John, Matt, Charles, and Sean back riding with us, and I believe, I know, they will all be back.
Well, you didn't get combed, but this hit will hurt a lot more than any bullet in the head.
Especially when we rob this train, too.
Yeah, I guess we'll see about that.
Oh, indeed we will.
You know, he'll come after us.
Oh, of course he will. Just like all the rest. But we're gonna stay a step ahead of them. Make sure we always know where they are before they know where we are. We allowed ourselves to get a step behind at Blackwater. That won't happen again. All right, dig in, fellas. Let's make some ground.
Please don't!
What's your name, boy?
I don't know.
You don't know your name?
It's Kieran.
Kieran what?
Duffy. Kieran Duffy.
Well, I ain't gonna lie to you. This is a real bad day for you, Kieran Duffy.
Where are you taking me?
Somewhere you ain't gonna like.
Why? What are you gonna do to me?
Something you ain't gonna like. So I'd advise you to save your breath for screaming.
No, please! Come on, mister, please! I'm no use to you!
You better shut your mouth, you little shitter. I will shut it for you.
Oh, God, please, no.
Are you trying to test me? Is that it? Because I will break every bone in your body.
okay?
Not one more goddamn word. Am I clear?
Okay.
That's two bones right there. Sack of shit. Let's introduce you to the boys.
Don't hurt me, please.
No, don't worry. They're real nice.
Huh. Found a little shit, did you?
Yep. I got him.
Very good. Welcome to your new home. Hope you're real happy here.
You want me to make him talk?
Oh, no. Now all we'll get is lies. Uncle, Mr. Williamson, tie this maggot up someplace safe. We get him hungry first. I got a saying, my friend. You shoot fellas as need shooting, save fellas as need saving, and feed them as need feeding. We are gonna find out what you need. I can't believe it! An O'Driscoll in my camp!
I ain't an O'Driscoll, mister! I hate that fella!
Oh, whatever you say, son. Well done, Arthur.
I'm just sorry we missed out on Colm.
Oh, there's time enough for that. Now, I gotta figure out if we can hit that train.
Okay.
We're gonna starve to death up here, Mr. Morgan.
We're okay.
We have a few cans of food and a rabbit. For what, 10, 12 people?
When I was in the Navy...
I do not wish to hear about what you got up to in the Navy, Mr. Pearson.
We were stranded at sea for 50 days.
And you unfortunately survived.
When we ran away from Blackwater, I wasn't able to get supplies in.
Well, when government agents are hunting you down, sometimes shopping trips need to be cut short. We'll survive. We always have. If needs be, we can eat you. You're the fattest.
I sent Lenny and Bill hunting, and they found nothing.
Well, Lenny's more into book learning than hunting. Bill's a fool. Unless those mountains are full of game that want to read, ain't no wonder they found
enough of this. We'll go find something. Come on, Arthur.
Wait a second. Hold on. Here. You're gonna need something to eat out there.
Assorted, salted offal. Starving will be preferable.
Come on, let's go.
You can't go hunting. Look at your hand.
I can't stay here listening to you two. Look, if there's game in those hills, I'll find it. And you can kill it.
You need to rest, Charles.
You think this is rest? Come along. Here, you take this. I can't use it, and you'll have to.
Oh, you're joking.
Use a gun, and we'll scare off every animal for miles around. You're never too old to learn, I imagine. Come on, this way.
Whoa! How are you holding up, Charles?
I'm okay.
apart from this hand. Stupid mistake.
Still bad?
It'll be fine in a day or two. I just can't pull a bow right now.
Sure hope I can. Never really got the hang of it.
You'll be fine.
So, you reckon we're gonna find something to kill that ain't no Driscoll?
Huh. There's meat up here for sure. Pearson doesn't know what he's talking about. Now the weather's eased off a bit, they'll be needing to feed. We'll head up this way, find some higher ground.
Been a wild few days, all right. That ride north from Blackwater, getting stuck in the storm, going out for John, that thing with the O'Driscoll.
You've had a lot put on you. I wish I could have done more.
I didn't mean it like that, just a lot to think back on.
I still don't really know what happened on that boat.
Move it, come on.
So, yeah, where were we?
Dean Nate. Well, Javier told me a bit, but it sure weren't good. There's some patches of grass here. This is good. Come on, let's try this way. Keep your eyes peeled for movement. The wind's died down, too. That's good.
No wind at all is bad, but if it's too strong, they won't move. Now, shh. Stay quiet. Hey, stop here a second. I see something.
Oh, watch it.
There's deer been here recently.
How can you tell?
How can you not? We'll track them on foot. You're gonna need the bow. Don't leave it on your horse. A gun will scare everything around. Grab that bow off the horse. Quiet. As you can. Stay low and move slowly. You see the tracks?
I think so. Maybe not.
Focus. But once you get your eye in, you'll be able to track nearly as well in grass and woods. Thank you. see him? Quick, get that bow out, Arthur. Try to hit him in the neck or head. Quick and clean. Keep good tension on the string before we release it. Just don't overdo it. Now, Arthur. Didn't kill it. You should go finish it off. Keep following the tracks, Arthur. Thank you.
Okay, that'll do it.
I think that's all we can carry.
This packed on my horse.
Ready to head back when you are.
Come on, then. Let's head back.
Whoa.
Nice work, Arthur. Should be enough meat here to keep us all fed for a few days.
You found him.
Careful. I knew you'd be okay with that bow.
It's easier when they ain't shooting back.
We've seen enough of that.
Considering how things were looking a couple of days back, well, maybe our luck's finally on the turn.
Seems to me we should be putting our effort into getting off this mountain now.
Soon. People are still weak, and well, you've seen how snowed in those wagons are. They ain't going nowhere until we get some more thaw.
You're probably right. And even if we do get off here, what then? We still have a big price on our heads.
This is a big country. We'll find somewhere to lie low. Dutch and Jose will have a plan. You notice how Pearson's had a bottle in his hand ever since we fled Blackwater? We give the camp cook 5 minutes to grab the essentials and go. And he doesn't even bring a crumb of food.
Good that we caught more than one. We've only been up here a few days and have already picked up 2 more mouths to feed.
One more. We ain't feeding the O'Driscoll a damn thing. Except maybe that can of salted offal Pearson was kind enough to give us.
The girl, she has a wild look in her eye.
Of course. She lost her husband, her home, everything she had.
So what do we do with her?
Well, once we get out of here and we're back on our feet, we'll see. She might have family somewhere.
Who knows? Maybe she'll deal with the O'Driscoll for us.
Well, I know who my money's on in that fight. He's weak, but that makes him much more useful. Maybe we can get to them before they get to us.
What is it with the O'Driscolls?
You ain't dealt with them? I suppose. Yeah, we ain't run into them much the last 6 months. I guess because they've been over this way.
Yeah. I've heard a lot of talk about them.
Well, we've been scrapping over scores with them for years. Big gang. Nasty sons of bitches. Their leader, Combe, and Dutch go way back. And not in a good way. A proper blood feud.
Watch out. Bear up ahead. Let's see if we can find another way around. You must be real hungry. Stay well back. Spring storms like this are the worst for animals that sleep all winter.
Stop carrying on.
What are you doing? Get him!
Arthur, you awake back there?
Yeah, just thinking. We ain't ever talked that much, you and me. How long you been with us now? 5-6 months?
Something like that.
But you didn't expect this.
What?
Any of this. Blackwater mess. Being up here.
Sooner or later, a job's gonna go wrong. Nature of life.
I just thought you might have moved on by now.
You want me to move on?
No. No, not at all. I know you could run it alone, no problem.
I did that for a long time. I'm done with it. Always wondering if someone's gonna kill you in your sleep.
I still wonder that most nights.
I reckon you're okay. This suits me. Sure, I could fall in with another gang, but Dutch. You know, Dutch is different.
Oh, yes. Dutch is certainly different.
He treats me fair. Most of you do. And for a fellow with a black father and an Indian mother, that ain't normally the case.
Well, we need you now. More than ever.
Good. How long have you been with these boys? Why ain't you run off?
Me? Since I was a boy.
20 years?
Yeah. Taught me to read. John, too. Taught me a few other things, him and Hosea.
Huh. I'm sure.
Dutch saved me. Saved most of us. That's why we need to stick by him through this. He always sees us right.
How's that new horse?
He's all right. He'll do for now. I appreciate you letting me take Taima the other night.
She's a strong one. It's been as hard on the horses as on the rest of us. I don't know what Dutch would do if something happened to the Count.
Same with Bill and Brown Jack. He's a drunk, miserable bastard, but he loves that horse.
I hope they all make it.
I tried to ride the Count once. Me faster than a bull. Won't take nobody but him.
I'm gonna hitch time over here.
Brought some food back, boys! Come on, let's get these over to Pearson.
Thank you for showing me how to use the bow properly.
I only showed you a little. There's a lifetime of practice to master.
Well, well, well! Just drop it down in here.
What a surprise. Found a camp rat loitering around in the kitchen.
Is that any way to greet an old friend? I feel like we haven't spoken for days.
I do my utmost to avoid.
Why, he loves me, really. It's his sad way of showing affection.
No, it isn't. Now shoot, get lost.
See you gents later.
See, you got on just fine.
Charles is a wonder.
Have a drink, boys. You earned it. Jesus, what is that? Navy rum, sir. It's the only thing. The only thing. Keeps you sane, it does.
Yeah, oh. Seems to have done a treat on you. You go rest that hand, Charles.
We'll be fine in a few days.
You mind helping me with the skinning, Mr. Morgan? It's easier if we do it together.
We'll get to...
You're always one with the jokes, aren't you? Come on.
This really isn't a job for a man with a burnt hand. I'll see you both later.
You skin that one, you dumped on the floor there. Not too bad, Mr. Morgan. Yeah. They always said you were a butcher. You know, you could trade these or sell these in pretty much any town. If you're looking to make a legitimate bit of money, of course.
Right now, I'm just looking to get off this mountain alive.
Well, if you catch anything else, you bring it to me.
Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Heck, Arthur Morgan's first decent bit of hunting after all these years.
Yeah. Well, we're on the run now. Everyone's got to do their bit to survive. Just make a good stew. Folk need it. It's been a tough few days.
been a bad few weeks. But Dutch being Dutch, he is busy making plans. And Dutch being Dutch, those plans involve robbery and dreams. Well, I thought you was reading him his last rites. Now I see you're introducing him to your other passion.
I'll mind you to show me some respect, Mr. Morgan.
Mind away, Reverend. You're still here, then?
I owe you.
Yeah. And you'll pay me. But for the moment, just rest.
Arthur! I think it's time for the train.
Want me to come?
Of course I do, but look at you.
I was always ugly, Dutch. It's just a scratch.
Don't lie still, son. Hello, Abigail.
Dutch.
Jackie.
The boy wanted to see you, John.
He's seen me now. Or what's left of me. What about you?
Guess I was hoping to see a corpse.
Bide your time. You'll see plenty of them.
You're a rotten man, John Marston.
He is an idiot, Abigail. We all know it. Now, railway men. Bill, now you ride ahead and set the charge at the water tower just before the tunnel.
Ain't a problem.
Why are we doing this? Weather's breaking. We could leave. I thought we was lying low.
Yeah. Come on.
What do you want from me, Hosea?
I just don't want any more folks to die, Dutch.
We're living, Hosea. We're living. Look at me. We're living. Even you. But we need money. Everything we have's in Blackwater. You fancy heading back there?
No. Listen, Dutch, I ain't trying to undermine you. I just want to stick to the plan, which was to lie low, then head back out west. Now, suddenly, we're about to rob a train.
What choice have we got?
Leviticus Cornwall's no joke, Dutch. Well,
who is Leviticus Cornwall?
He's a big railway magnate, sugar dealer, oil man.
Well, how good for him. Sounds like he has more than enough to share.
Dutch!
Gentlemen, it is time to make something of ourselves. Get your horses ready. We have a train to rob.